Okay, I've got a new method of recording here, which should work better. I have the webcam going as well, in case that's helpful. So today we're going to cover our second topic, Chapter 5, which is about vision as well. In this case, it's about visual object recognition. And so we're going to start going through the topics from Chapter 5 here. I wanted to also point you guys out to a couple things about the textbook. There are some questions at the end of each chapter. And then I think there's even a website with some resources that accompany this textbook. If you search for Essentials of Cognitive Neuroscience Hospital. And then you can go to this instructor companion site and you can get things regarding each chapter, like little web clips and multiple choice questions. So I'll post this link here for everyone on eClass. And I'll even do that right now. So I'll add a URL here and the URLs to the textbook and the site. Okay, so you can click on that link to find that information. Now let's just look briefly at the syllabus again. I'll close some of these things, and so here's the syllabus. Hasn't changed much since we went over it in class. You can contact myself and the TA in these ways. Reminder that on Tuesdays, except for this week and last, we're going to meet in the computer lab in Education South 155B, and we're going to work through the EGEDU modules there. Other than that, not much has changed. We have the midterms, one coming up on the 30th of January, and we have weekly lab assignments that we're going to hand in each week on eClass. And then we also will have our assignment itself, which I'll be posting a bigger description of the grade breakdown and what you'll need to do for the assignment. But it's going to be a handing in of a paper which reports some of the experiments that we do in the lab. And then I updated the schedule so that it was more clear. So here we are today on January 16th. And so you can see that coming Tuesday is our first day in the lab, and then it's going to alternate between the classroom and the lab. We're going to have a midterm, and then we have reading week, and then in the later parts of the schedule, in addition to continuing to go to the lab, we're going to meet in the classroom and work on some parts of the writing. Your assignment will be due just at the start of the exam period, probably on April 15th. Okay, so now that we've gone over the schedule and over any additional things on eClass, so you can see here that I will publish some study questions and a practice exam as well before the midterm to give you a sense of what kind of questions are going to be on. So here's an example. And this particular exam is very much a recap of 275 that you might want to try as well. Let me make that visible right now. So I will show that, but I will hide these for now. And you can have a look at that practice exam. Okay, so we're going to continue the lecture with topic 2, which is chapter 5 of the textbook on visual object recognition. I'll make this full screen, and I will turn on the closed captioning as well. One issue is that our video will only be able to record for 15 minutes, so after 10 minutes we'll switch to another video. Okay, so far in the class we've covered this material that was recap from 275, and then last week we covered a kind of a basic introduction to the visual system and talked about a number of techniques that we'll bring up again and again in the course, like TMS, optical imaging, and EEG, and magnetic resonance imaging. So we're going to cover a lot of those as we go through when we talk about specific studies. But if you have any questions related to any of these particular techniques, please ask them. Today we're going to cover this topic on visual object recognition. So when we look around the world throughout the day and we see certain patterns of visual stimuli, we can identify them as individual objects: lamps, tables, computers, cars, bikes, people, and face out of the neck to your exact ganglions, which part of part of inner and shape, very fun visual. So lateral, where we talk about, we're gonna text us at the tension area. And the two visual and caps up maps into visions come, which vision, and we're gonna have optic ray represent arc of the block, those as elect spring text color, part of the what pathway. Let's check our time here. I'm going to stop this first video here, actually, just to make sure it doesn't get lost, and I'll start up in the next video.